हेलो स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट अवर यूनिट सेकंड, वेपर एंड गैस पावर साइकल्स. टॉपिक्स: द सिलेबस ऑफ यूनिट 3 इज कार्नोट साइकिल, आइडियल रैंकिंग साइकिल, रीहीट एंड रीजनरेशन, स्टर्लिंग साइकिल, जूल बैट्रॉन साइकिल, कैलकुलेशन ऑफ थर्मल इफिशियंसी, स्पेसिफिक स्टीम पर फ्यूल कंजम्पशन, वर्क रेशो फॉर अबव साइकिल. Now we will start our first topic of unit 3, Carnot cycle. The figure shows the Carnot engine. Carnot cycle on PV diagram in second figure and Carnot cycle on TS diagram in figure 3. It consists of two constant pressure operation, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, and two frictionless adiabatic operations, 2 to 3 and 4 to 1. These operations are discussed below. Process 1 to 2. 1 kg of boiling water at temperature T1 is heated to form the wet steam of dryness fraction X1. The heat is absorbed at constant temperature T1 and pressure P1 during this operation. Process 2 to 3. During this operation, steam is expand isentropically. The pressure and temperature falls from P2 to P3 and T2 to T3. Since no heat is supplied or rejected during this process, therefore there is no change of entropy. The process represented by the curve 2 to 3. Now the process 3 to 4. During this operation, the wet steam at point 3 is now isothermally condensed in condenser and the heat is rejected at constant temperature T3 and pressure P3. It means that temperature T4 and pressure P4 is equal to temperature T3 and pressure P3 respectively. This isothermal process is represented by the curve 3 to 4. Now fourth process 4 to 1. The wet steam at a point 4 is finally compressed isentropically in compressor. The temperature and pressure rises from P4 to P1 and temperature T4 to T1 respectively. Now, Carnot efficiency equal to work done by heat supplied equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by heat supplied. Now, heat supplied Q 1 to 2 equal to P1 V1 ln V2 upon V1 MR T1 ln gamma. V2 upon V1 ratio is a compression ratio, so it denote as gamma. Now heat rejected Q 3 to 4 P3 V3 ln V3 upon V4 MR T3 ln into gamma. Now NC equal to Carnot efficiency equal to MRT1 ln gamma minus MRT3 ln gamma upon MRT1. Now T1 minus T3 upon T1. Therefore cycle efficiency is denoted by 1 minus T3 minus T3 upon T1, where T1 is the highest temperature corresponding to the boiler pressure P1 equal to P2 and T3 equal to lowest temperature corresponding to the condenser pressure P3 equal to P4. Now we will move the limitation of Carnot cycle. Though the Carnot cycle is simple and has the high thermal efficiency for given value of T1 and T2, yet it is extremely difficult to operate in practice because of following reason. First reason, it is difficult to compress the wet vapor isentropically to saturated state as required by the process 3 to 4. It is very difficult to control the quality of condensed coming out of the condenser. Third, the efficiency of Carnot cycle is greatly affected by the temperature T1. And fourth one, the cycle is still more difficult to operate with the superheated steam.